lot of political civil unrest going on, and kind of mentioned, as you'll see, he mentioned in there that had maybe a little bit to do with the decision to kind of change their environment.
No, it was just, you know, the civil rights movement was coming to a climax, and the agitation for Voting Rights Act and Civil Rights Act. So for Black Americans, it was a very stressful time, a very crucial time. And that's very much on my mind. I've been aware of the civil rights movement ever since I was a kid.
Is there like some stories that you remember? Because I know before you came to Alto when I was in college in the 90s, I know I've seen some of my classmates around there. But we had a lot going on too with Rodney King, the riots, and it was kind of reminded me a little bit of your time, you know, a lot of things that were going on. And I know that you had Martin and other leaders that were very influential people while you were growing up, and how did that affect you?
Well, you know, for a Black person who was in the late 60s, in a very crucial time, Dr. King was agitating for a civil rights bill, and Black Americans were demanding to vote and be treated like first class citizens. And there was a lot of resistance and pushback, and it really had I like a lot. In addition to that, there was a Vietnamese war.
Yeah.
And then, you know, Muhammad Ali spoke out against the Vietnam War. He got everybody, all Black Americans, on one side with him. He said, ain't gonna be a cop ever called me nigger. Well, these Black Americans understood what that meant. So, you know, it was a very divisive time, and it was tough. It was a tough time to get through.
I know Martin spoke here at UCLA. I wonder if you were you here when he had a speech here, or right before he came?
No, I never saw Dr. King speak at UCLA. I saw Dr. King speak when I was in high school. Between my junior and senior years in high school, I took part in a mentoring program that was run by Dr. John Henry Clark, who was a sociologist and historian. He had Dr. King come and address the kids that took part in the program. And because I was from the journalism workshop, again, my writing was going. I got a chance to ask Dr. King a question, and you know, I got a chance to talk to him. Very, very good, eventful time. So Dr. King told us that of all the people that were taking part in the program, we had nothing to worry about because we were already at that point thinking about how to make our home, Harlem, a better place, and thinking about what to do, and thinking about maybe going to school, and bringing back some knowledge and expertise to make Harlem a better place.
So Coach Wooden, who came for, you know, in basketball, you know, you go to the home to visit the guys that you try to get to come in school, and in your book you talk about the home visit with you and Coach, and what did you think about having such, you know, a famous coach come to your home and speak to your parents? I never had that.
That was pretty neat, yeah, it was. But when they got there, Coach Wooden and Coach Long were there. You know, we spoke a little bit, and then when they got ready to get down to the serious conversation, I had to leave the room. I figured I was in control because I wasn't going to go anywhere that I didn't want to go. And my parents weren't going to force me, you know, so it didn't end up being any kind of.
So when you saw how that went, your parents, they were comfortable sending you to the West Coast?
Oh yeah, they were impressed with Coach, and Coach was impressed with them, and it was good evening here.
Well, we're glad you came to the West. Thank you, Coach.